So Congressman Tevis's team is insinuating that the murder child, the murder charges or these complaints that have come out from a 2019 case right after the death of Governor De Gamo, it's politically motivated. He even insinuated that it had to do with money and business dealings within the province.
I am not aware of those circumstances or motivations, ma'am, no? But when is the right time to file a complaint for murder? The prescriptive period for murder is 20 years. So you can file a murder case within that 20-year period. And it so happened that we had a breakthrough in our quest for justice. And we were able to convince these witnesses to help government. In fact, one of those participants in the killings was crying. He was so remorseful, and he is willing to help government. And the CIDG has all these witnesses with them.
But why did these witnesses suddenly surface 4 years after the killing?
My objective analysis, ma'am, based on my discussion with them also, is that they also fear for their own lives because one of them was tasked to eliminate one of their colleagues. And he did that. And he realized eventually that he might be soon a subject for elimination also. That's why he flee the confines of the Tevez circle.
Mm-mm. So you represent more than 15 families in this case. Based on your conversations with these families and now the widow of Governor De Gamo, what is the reputation of Congressman Tevez in the province? What is he known for?
Ma'am, from what I gathered, his politics is feudalistic. He wants full control of the population, and he would. There is a saying there that what Tevez wants, Tevez gets.
Now you initiated, your camp initiated the complaint in the lower house, the ethics committee in the lower house, that actually led to his expulsion. And interestingly, you brought out the fact that Congressman Tevez actually owns a franchise of a small town lottery, or STL, because Attorney Topacio admits that when Isabong was legal, Tevez had an Isabong. Pero ngayon daw na hindi na legal ang Isabong, he no longer has an Isabong. So let's talk about his ownership and his involvement in gambling.
Okay, ma'am. Just a point of clarification. Mm-hmm. I am not involved, or I was not involved in the recent ethics case involving Congressman Tevez. I think it was a House-initiated disciplinary action against him. Mm-hmm. But for our side, we are contemplating of filing our own ethics complaint case involving the direct or indirect financial interests of Congressman Tevez over certain numbers game, like the small town lottery. Mm-hmm. And even Isabong, no? Even if Isabong or small town lottery are legal, having direct or indirect interest over this numbers game is constitutionally prohibited when the interest comes from a member of Congress. No? Mm. The Constitution is very specific. Any member of Congress cannot have direct or indirect financial interest over contracts with, franchise, or special privilege coming from the government or any agency, instrumentality, or government-owned or controlled corporation. And through his lawyer, he admitted that he has interest over the small town lottery and even Isabong when it was legal. No? So These are the ultimate facts that will comprise our complaint against him for expulsion.
Yeah, and under the law, you believe that this is enough to actually expel Congressman Tevez from the lower house. Is there a precedent of any other congressman being expelled from the lower house on the same grounds, or were other expulsions based on other issues? I know that the other expulsions were HRET related, right? HRET related. Pero pagdating po sa ethics, meron na po bang na-expel?
Ma'am, in the previous cases, the contumacious conduct of the member of the Congress involve minor criminal offenses. Like, for example, if you remember the case of Congressman Gonzalez.
I do.
When he when he hit the sergeant at arms, he was merely suspended. Mm-hmm. But these are minor criminal offenses. Mm-hmm. But when the Constitution speaks of certain requirements for membership in the House, like age, citizenship, if you do not possess those qualifications, you can be expelled. And there is another continuing requirement in the Constitution, that is Section 14 of Article 6 of the Constitution, that no member of Congress shall have any financial interest over franchises, etc.
Very good. Mm-hmm.
And that is
a yun?
Opo.
Oh,
and that is a continuing prohibition for any member of the House that is enshrined no less in our basic law, the Constitution.
Mm-mm. So when Attorney Ferdy Topacio yesterday admitted that Congressman Tevez was involved in Isabog when it was legal, Congressista na siya noon.
Yes, ma'am. And even if...
Go on.
So even if Isabog was legal, the fact that he was a member of Congress, that is a prohibited transaction that a member of Congress should enter into.
Mm-mm.
It is prohibited.
Oh, but do you have evidence that he actually runs the small town lottery in the province? Is it in the province or in the district?
Ma'am, it's in several places, even beyond the province of Negros Oriental. But for now, we will base our evidence on their own admission. No? Even Congressman Tevez himself admitted that he had the Isabong operation before. Those are admissions against interest that are admissible as evidence. Now, for corroborative evidence, we have certain politicians in Negros who will attest to the fact that it is Congressman Arnie Tevez who is operating the small town lottery there, and even the Isabong before.
And these politicians are willing to go on the record?
Ma'am, for now, they have in their possession a document that they are about to sign.
Okay, so clearly you are moving forward. Let's go now to the Degamo case. Is there concrete evidence or any kind of admission that Arnie Tevez was behind the death of Degamo and eight others?
Ma'am, I would like to defer to the wisdom of the Secretary of Justice, which whom I talked with yesterday. Mm-hmm. And they are now processing the statements of the nine remaining direct participants in the killings, meaning the nine former soldiers. Mm-hmm. They are now processing their statements, and we have good indications that we can achieve justice very soon.
Okay. Now, Attorney Baligod, it's 2019 to 2023, this is the 21st century. You know, we would think, in fact, no less than President Marcos Jr. was shocked right? That in today's time, a brazen political killing such as this would still happen in today's modern times, and rightly so. So why would, if Congressman Tevez were truly involved in these killings, the death of that counselor in 2019 to now Governor Degamo, why would he be this brazen?
Ma'am, because he has enablers, no less from the Philippine National Police Organization. There was an incident that Congressman Tevez celebrated his birthday early in the morning, two platoons of police personnel rendered the mañanita for him. And one police officer was even dancing in a way that was so demeaning to the image of the Philippine National Police. And to think that Congressman Tevez at that time was even wearing a sleeveless shirt and in just short pants, no?
Nakakabiseta.
Oh, tapos yung mga police ay naka-uniforme pa. And they were dancing before him. So it is correct, ma'am, that it is quite unbelievable that this can happen in the 21st century. Mm-hmm. But in fact, in so many other pockets of places in our country, this is happening. But the national government and concerned agencies of government had defaulted on their obligation to the nation. Imagine, ma'am, there is a breakdown of the criminal justice system in Negros Oriental. Mm-hmm. Imagine, there was one family who was seeking the assistance of a lawyer, mm-hmm. but nobody wanted to render that legal assistance. And then eventually, there was one lawyer that they were able to engage. And after paying him his acceptance fee, during the first hearing, he was the one even threatening the family.
Really?
That led the family to execute an affidavit of desistance.
But you actually reveal a very interesting point of a bigger problem that needs to be solved, that the PNP has become enablers locally, and that should be addressed, which is why there are private armies in provinces, which is why there are politicians who still carry on this kind of feudalistic method. It is the police force that's quite strong. Have you ever, I'm curious, in terms of policy, brought this up, let's say for alam ko nagpadala na po ng 50 man elite team, no, sa Negros, but this is temporary. But in terms of the rotation of the PNP, do you believe it's a good case study that they should be rotated?
That's a very bad policy, actually, ma'am, because you are just exporting to another place the defective character of a police officer. He commits atrocities in one place, you mm-hmm. just export him to another place. Mm-hmm. He will do the same kind of he will lead his life similarly. That's why, ma'am, it is a challenge for the government to start the reform measures at the recruitment and selection stage pa lamang.
Yeah. Okay. But let's move on. Just my last question is, so you will still file a complaint for expulsion in the lower house against Congressman Tevez? And what are you hopeful for that this be acted on? Because there is, I believe, a 6-week break. They're on recess starting today, no? So I think for 6 weeks. So kailan niyo po ito mapafile when they resume?
No, ma'am, we can, because the administrative process in the House that is not also suspended. It is only the session that is suspended, so we can still file it. And the very reason why my clients are prompted to file this case is because of the statement, no less, of the leadership of the House of Representatives that they will not condone among them an erring member. And in fact, I was able to listen to the statement of no less than Speaker Martin Romualdez that he was demanding from PNP a result, a positive result from the investigation. Nagalit pa nga siya noon sa PNP. And I think that is the character of Speaker Romualdez. He will not tolerate shenanigans. And we look forward to working with them to help preserve the good image of the House of Representatives to the Filipino nation.
On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, Attorney Levito Baligod. Mag-ingat po kayo, sir, and I do hope to have you once again on Head Start.
Thank you, ma'am, for having me. Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat.
Good morning to you.